Professor Dave again, let's talk about the Divergence Theorem.
He knows a lot about all kinds of stuff, Professor Dave explains.
Green's theorem gave us an additional method for calculating a line integral around a closed curve. Now we will introduce an additional method of calculating the surface integral for a closed surface S. By this, we mean that we have some solid region in space, and its boundary will be our surface. Recall that the surface integral for this will be expressed as the surface integral over S of f dot n ds, where f is some vector field permeating space, and n is the normal vector of the surface. The divergence theorem, also called Gauss's theorem, states that this surface integral is equal to the triple integral over the solid region of the divergence of f dv. Here, dv is our differential volume, which in Cartesian xyz coordinates will simply be dx, dy, dz. Let's take a look at an example to see how to apply this theorem. Consider the surface of this triangular prism, which occupies x from 0 to 1 and y from 0 to 2. It has a flat base in the xy plane, and the top surface is given by the plane z equals 1 minus x. Now let's say there's a vector field in this space, which is given by f equals xy, yz, zx. If we wanted to calculate the surface integral of this field over the surface S without using the theorem, we would have to split each of the five flat surfaces of the prism into their own surface integrals and calculate each individually. Luckily, the divergence theorem reduces our work to one triple integral over the region of the prism. The divergence theorem states that the surface integral will be equal to the triple integral of the divergence of f over the region. So first, let's find the divergence of f. Recall that the divergence of a vector field is del dot f, where del equals d dx, d dy, d dz. So for this case, the divergence will be del dot f equals y plus z plus x. Now we have the divergence, but before integration, we must get our bounds sorted out. We get these from the region of our prism. One simple way to express these bounds is integrating z first, letting it run from 0 to 1 minus x. Now we don't have any more complicated bounds, so we can integrate y from 0 to 2 and x from 0 to 1. So our integral ends up being the integral from 0 to 1, the integral from 0 to 2, the integral from 0 to 1 minus x of y plus z plus x, dz dy dx. Integrating z first, we get yz plus z squared over 2 plus xz, where z is evaluated from 0 to 1 minus x. Factoring out a z and evaluating, we get 1 minus x, y plus 1 minus x over 2 plus x, or simplifying the x terms, 1 minus x, y plus x over 2 plus 1 half. Next, we must integrate with respect to y, which gives us 1 minus x, y squared over 2 plus xy over 2 plus y over 2, where y is evaluated from 0 to 2. Evaluating this, we get 1 minus x times 2 plus x plus 1, or just 1 minus x times x plus 3. Now if we multiply this out, we get the integral of x plus 3 minus x squared minus 3x dx. Simplifying gives us 3 minus 2x minus x squared. Integrating, we get 3x minus x squared minus x cubed over 3, where x runs from 0 to 1. And finally, evaluating gives us 3 minus 1 minus 1/3, simplifying to 5/3. This is the value of our surface integral, which we used the divergence theorem to calculate. The divergence theorem is another useful tool for calculations, and it has a variety of applications. In fact, the theorem is used in Gauss's law to relate the flux of an electric field, which would be the surface integral part of the theorem, to the amount of charge contained within the volume, which would be the triple integral part of the theorem. And with this, we've wrapped up another section of mathematics. But before we go on to more advanced topics, let's check comprehension. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.